पॉम्फ्रेट भुजना। Hi, welcome to Sanjeev Kapoor's Khazana. I'm Rupa here and I'm going to demonstrate today some Konkani dishes. To begin with, we are doing pomfret bhujna. I'll go ahead and show you all the ingredients. Two medium-sized pomfret sliced into thicker slices. Onion 2 to 3 chopped finely, 3 tablespoons. Freshly grated coconut, turmeric 1 teaspoon, 1.5 teaspoon chili powder, 2 tablespoons chopped coriander leaves, about 1 tablespoon, finely chopped ginger, 1/2 teaspoon garam masala, 1 finely chopped chili, and these are kokums, so that's approximately 4-5 pieces. This is coconut oil for drizzling, and this is cooking oil and salt for taste. So let's start with the recipe now. To begin with, take some oil, about 2 tablespoons of it. It goes to say that a long time back, because of fish and rice and coconut there, the Brahmins from there, which are called as Gaud Saraswat Brahmins, I'm one of them, we were granted the wish by God to eat fish. So we are Brahmins, but we are allowed to eat fish and granted to eat fish because we could survive, because we come from the seaside coastal belt. So a lot of rice, a lot of fish, and a lot of coconut. So to begin with, we start preparing all our dishes with these three ingredients. So now the oil is warm enough, we'll add the onions to it. Fry the onions till it gets little translucent or pink in color. This amsole is also the fruit which is grown there, red in color like a cherry. Then it's dried and kept and stored throughout the year. We avoid using tamarind or lemon because this is only grown in the Konkan belt. It gives a nice pink color. It's used in sol kadhi, and otherwise for all the dishes which require sourness, we normally use amsol. Till the onions are getting translucent, we'll marinate the fish. Salt, 1/2 a teaspoon haldi powder, 1.5 chili powder, 1/2 garam masala. Just rub in the dry powder masala into the fish and leave it till the onions are getting pink in color. If required, you can put a little water to just help in the marination. The onions are getting translucent. I'll add the green chilies to it, approximately 1 green chili. Add the fish to it. Reduce the flame, very gently toss the fish in the onion. As I said, this is a stir-fry dish. It doesn't take a lot of moisture in it, but little water can go in for the cooking of the fish. And add a little water for the cooking. Cover and cook for 5 minutes. When it's getting cooked, we will add the grated coconut, coriander leaves, and the chopped ginger. Okay, now we are adding the coconut, the ginger, and the coriander leaves. Mix it with very light and gentle, because it's a little semi-dry dish, so I don't want the fish to break. After adding the coriander, coconut, and the ginger, I'm adding a little water that you have to adjust as the water gets evaporated or as it gets absorbed into the dish. Don't make it too watery. Let it cook in its own juices that is there. We are covering it for around 2 minutes till the moisture gets absorbed, and the fish will cook in a minute or so. Let's check on the fish whether it's cooked. Yeah, the fish is cooked now. We can add the amsol and drizzle it with little coconut oil. This is the amsol. Just add them. This is coconut oil. Just drizzle it. Coconut oil will give a nice aroma and flavor to the dish. Cover and cook for 5 minutes. We'll check on the dish. I think it's done. We can take it out in the serving plate. Take out the pieces very gently. As you can see, papled bhujna is ready. This dish, you can have it with bhakri, chapati, or dal and rice. I'm sure the simple stir-fry version of fish will be lovely to taste, and you should try it.